Professor Liu gave the same quiz to the students in her morning class and in her afternoon class. The average score for the two classes combined was 84. Which class had more students? So average is equal to your sum over your total, or in this case, our average, which is 84, is equal to the sum of our scores for our two classes. So that would mean our scores from the morning class plus the scores from the afternoon class. So the sum of our scores over the total number of students. So that would be our students in the morning class plus our students in the afternoon class. So we'll say M and A represent the number of students in each class. Other than that, don't know much. So we want to know if M is greater than A. Question one, the average score for the students in the morning class was 80. So what does that mean here? So remember, so these, this here reflects the sum of all the scores in the morning class. This here is the sum of all my scores in my afternoon class. So if the average score in the morning class was 80, well, first of all, so we can sort of say this is gonna be insufficient just because it doesn't tell us anything about the afternoon class. But if we want to still somehow put this into our equation, well, this is telling us, how could we sum up the scores in our morning class? Well, it should be the average for that class times the number of students in that class. So if we want to, we can write, so 84 is equal to 80, the average score for the morning class times M. And then in fact, it looks like we'll be able to do the same thing for statement two for the afternoon class. So here we'll just have 80 times M plus scores for the afternoon class over M plus A. So again, this isn't super helpful because we don't know anything about that. Statement two says the average score for the students in the afternoon class was 86. So again, by itself, this is going to be insufficient. So we can sort of go straight to looking at them together, and it's insufficient again because we don't know anything about the morning class. Now, so together, so we can do two things. A, you can just sort of think about this. Say our classes had the same number of students. That means each class, if we think of this as a weighted average, each class is weighted equally, and the average score for the two classes should just be the simple average, which would give us an average of 83. But we know our average is 84, so what does that mean? That means our average is weighted a little more towards the scores from this class here. So that means the afternoon class must have some more students than the morning class. So based on that, you can just sort of, if you understand conceptually how weighted averages work, you can reason out that way. Or if you want to sort of prove it on paper, you can say, okay, what do I know when I'm looking at them together? So my average, my total average for the two classes should be equal to the sum of my scores for the morning class, which is 80 times the number of students in my morning class, that's what M is, plus 86 times the number of students in my afternoon class, which is A. So 86 times A all over M plus A. Now, we can't solve for anything really here, but say we were to just simplify this equation. So multiply each side here by M plus A maybe. So we get 84 times M plus A is equal to 80M plus 86A. So if we distribute this, we get 84. M plus 84A is equal to 80M plus 86A. And then we can so subtract, this is a zero, subtract 80M from each side, and we get 4M, and then subtract 84A from each side, is equal to 2A. So then finally, if we want to get just everything in terms of one of the classes, divide each side by 4, and so M is equal to 2/4 or 1/2 A. So the students in the morning class are equal to half the students in the afternoon class, even though we don't know how many students there are in either of the classes. We do know that the afternoon class have to have more kids. So this is sort of the proof of it. Like I said, if you understand weighted averages, you can just sort of reason it out. But either way, the answer is C.